Weird smell in there.
Death. It smelled like death.
I was thinking mildew with all the water.
Let's make an axe. What the hell? That's not fair.
Both the middle and inside pieces seem to move the outside ring.
Nice to see you, Shiva.
Come on, let's get this over and done with.
Yep.
Oh, shit! See? I told you it was dangerous. You hurt.
Just my dignity.
Here we go.
There'd be water. Now that's three.
You know,
you're pretty good at this whole treasure hunting thing.
I'm a quick study.
One question, though. I reckon that you could pretty much do anything you want. Why are you so keen to get Shoreline back?
Seriously? My partner turns my own men against me. My lieutenant makes off with a bounty. Nathan and Samuel Drake get off scot-free, and you're asking why I want Shoreline back.
Yeah.
It was on my watch. I lost it on my watch. All right, what the hell is that thing you keep playing with?
It's my stress toy. Showed up in the mail a few weeks after we got to Australia. All right, we better get a move on. We don't want a Sarv to get ahead of us. You know, I've had my fair share of screw-ups. You just pick yourself up and move on.
I don't like to fail.
No one does, love. Let's head back to the car. Gotta love a shortcut.
Glad we don't have to go back the way we came.
I would have made you dodge the axes.
If you want to look anywhere else out there, now's the time to do it.
Right. Look, for what it's worth, it's your kick-ass reputation that got you this job. Plus, I figured you could use the money.
You're not wrong.
Honestly, though, it's actually nice working with a woman for a change.
Too right. Not many of us out here. This one arms dealer demanded to speak to the man in charge, then tried backing out when I informed him I was running the show.
Ugh, what did you do?
Broke both his legs.
You're not kidding.
Just trying to level the playing field.
Oh, don't cross Ross.
I should put that one on my business card.
Can't you just walk away to be done with Shoreline?
I was born into it. I don't have a choice.
Oh, there's always a choice. Here we go. Coming.
Right behind you.
All righty, let's roll.
Magnificent. How long do you suppose it takes to carve something like this?
Years. Decades, even. The Hoi Salah certainly did have a knack for stonework.
And a war, it seems.
That too. They must have made these to commemorate their victories against the Persians.
Looks like they put up a good fight.
They did. Pity it didn't last. But their loss is our gain, right?
That carving looks familiar.
That carving is an exact match for the disc.
So what does that mean?
I don't know yet. But I'm guessing we should give that a try. Should we dance?
Try not to break it this way.
Sassy.
What the heck?
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Can't say I was expecting that. You ready?
Yeah. Just, taking it all in. Welcome to downtown Halabadoo. The last known resting place, the Task of Ganesh.
Spectacular.
Hmm.
And what?
Doesn't it look like there's a dam or something between the two Ganesh statues?
Must have been eroded by the falls.
So how do we get in?
Yeah. Look at the crown. It's not wear and tear.
You're right. Maybe it was a watchtower?
I bet that's how the Persians got in.
I have heard about this place for so long. I can't believe I'm actually looking at it.
You should take a picture. Send it to your dad.
Great idea.
What? You're one of those cultures who can't work a computer? Just take the picture. Show it to him in person, then.
No, it's just a few decades too late for that.
Look, I'm...
Oh, God, please, no.
It's fine.
Shall we,
head over to Halabadoo?
Hard to believe it's real.
Imagine what it took to make this. The craftsmen, the engineers.
Yeah. Their work still stands. But they're gone. Maybe their king should have used their wealth to protect his people and not make such an inviting target.
How we get up to the crown?
Did you bring the helicopter?
Left it at home.
Bum. Then I guess we're climbing. Okay. Ready?
You first.
Your way up. There, look. You can see some structures beneath the falls.
You know what? Where to now?
Look for a way up.
You know?
Look for a way up.
Okay. They're even more impressive up close.
My apologies. Up here, coming. Come on, this way.
You sure it's safe?
You know, you keep asking me that. It'll save us both some time if you just assume it's not. Oh boy! It's definitely not safe, by the way.
I saw. Think you can get back up here?
Yeah. Keep going. I'll catch up. All right, I can manage.
Just accept my help.
Come on up! But only because you said please.
I didn't, actually. I thought you said Ganesh was the removal of obstacles.
No, no, no!
Really the only way.
You having fun out there? You know it! Amazing. Fun, right?
That was the craziest thing I've ever done.
In a good way or bad way?
I'll let you know.
You're doing great, China.
Thanks. I'll be doing better when we get to the farm.
Surprised we haven't seen Saab yet. Knock on wood.
Oh, he's around. Doubt we'll see him up here.
Why's that?
He doesn't have the stones to climb this high.
I think I see a place we can swing over to the crown. Just a little farther to go. Thank you.
Hurry up and climb. I'm slipping.
Oh. Worth it?
Impressive.
Yeah.
Now, how do we get off this thing?
Okay. Easy does it.
All right. Feels more sturdy up here.
Don't jinx us. Here's our way in, courtesy of the Persian army. Nice shot.
Persians must have had a trebuchet.
Trebuchet? Can't you just say catapult like a normal person?
A trebuchet is a type of catapult. It can handle heavier projectiles, like this one. You fling them longer distances.
Right. You learned that in your military training?
I looked it up on Wikipedia. Like a normal person.
Ready?
After you.
Incredible. It's our old friends, Parashurama and Ganesh.
Friends? Looks like they're fighting.
Well, when the Hindu gods aren't off fighting demons, they're sometimes fighting each other.
What's wrong with their fight? Ganesh isn't an armed.
I guess it's not really his style.
Out of the mountain?
Sure, looks like it.
They barricaded the door. Didn't do them much good.
Guess they didn't expect the Persians to drop in from above.
You'd think after two prior invasions, they'd be prepared for anything.
Or they just never thought they'd be defeated. Must be a way out of this chamber. Through here. Hey, look. Armaments. You're right, Nadine.
I have my moments.
Now we're getting somewhere. Hey, another one of these doors. Now, let's see. Oh, good. This one actually works. Well, nice to get some light.
Feels like a crypt in here.
Hey, up here. What the hell?
Jesus. This was it? Their final stand?
Ugh. Wasn't enough to save their empire. But their loss is our gain. Here's our way in. Nadine, can you lend a hand with this chap?
Sure.
Come on, old fellow. There we go. Excuse me. Sorry.
We must be getting close.
Hopefully closer than these guys.
Well, this device looks familiar.
Let's hope it doesn't turn on the water in here. Well, that's different.
What is all this?
If I had a guess, I'd say it's some kind of lock mechanism to open that door. Okay, on the left, we have Shiva gifting Parashurama the axe. And on the right, we have Parashurama chopping off Ganesha's tusk.
Wait, with the axe?
Yeah.
The one that Shiva, Ganesha's father, gave to Parashurama?
Yeah.
It's messed up.
That's family. Come on, let's see about opening that door.
So how does all this work?
Only one way to find out. Let's see what this does. All right, that slid the piece away from me.
It's shutting the tube.
Let's try this. Nowhere for them to go. Over you go. I see what's happening.
The shadows look to me.
Right, so let's see if I can line them all up.
Okay, looks like fun.
Slide any further.